That's what you gotta worry about. You gotta keep everything tight. Boy, if you don't, you'd have that thing slip just minuscule. I mean, just real small. Now I don't wanna go down some more. Oh, I'll bring it down to 3/32, because see, 3 inches is an eighth of an inch. It'll cut an eighth of an inch high, and it won't make the curve.
Mm-hmm.
And you bring it down to 3/32. A 32nd underneath. And everything better be damn good and tight. You gotta lock everything down good and tight so nothing moves. If it just moves a hair, it can move things off on here a great deal. Okay. Now we gotta get the line running. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's the center line.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I put the center line there. So now you line the center line up with the center line up on here and make sure everything is straight. Now then, you're ready. Make sure everything lines up there pretty good. Now then we're ready to begin. Brass or silver or gold or things like this that the machine was originally designed for. But we'll cut steel, but you have to have better points. These are carbide that will cut steel. Regular steel won't do it. Okay, now we're gonna find out. Yeah, give it a cutting wall. And here we go. Straight and right, and if it isn't, we're back downstairs on my buffer machine and take all that out of there. Well, it looks like everything's going to be okay. We go to the next step down deeper here, and this thing has pumped up oil in there, so we know we got enough oil in there. Looks pretty good. Let's take it just a teeny bit more. That's just the depth, see? When you turn this way, it's going down to 15. If I take it all the way up to here, see? There's zero. There's nothing coming out of there. Then you go to here like 5, It goes down five thousandths. And 5 1/2, 10, 10 1/2. And we'll finish up right about in here. Top of the eight could be a little bit better.